on this online platform of OSU counseling class. So today we have been with us Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra. Actually, we don't need to need of his introduction because he has been taking our online class since 2 months, I guess. So he is faculty in political science department in Sambalpur University. And today he will be speaking on conceptual analysis of peace and conflict, nature and forms of conflict, interstate and interstate and global, and little bit touch upon the theories of war. So, sir, you can start your session now. Some more students have joined so far. So let's wait. They will join probably during this class. So let's start the session. And over to you, Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra, sir. Please start the session.
Thank you, Antarjami, and good morning, all of you. I can see only a few students are here, but there is a facility of recording and subsequently uploading it on YouTube. So I think the essence and the sense of talk is still there.
Yes, sir. Sir, one second, just I want to announce something. So it is request all the learners, whoever is in this platform, will give you 5 minutes after the session, and you can interact with our resource person. Like, he is so much interested to interact with you, and he want to take your feedbacks, how the class is going on, and what are the necessary thing you can do to make more interesting this class. So I would request all the participants to please stay with us till end the session. We have a chance to talk with our resource person, through which you can develop our different other aspect. Thank you, sir. Please, sir, continue.
Okay. So in the last class, I talked about peace, meaning nature's scope. And today, I'll speak on conflict and war. Why conflict happens? I mean, conflict happens everywhere at individual level. Conflict happens in the community level. Conflict happens in society. Conflict happens within state, between state. And conflict happens in the international arena also. So why a conflict happens? Now, primarily conflict happens, it's because of pursuit of incompatible goals. There is incompatible goals between individuals. There are incompatible goals between states. And where I'm saying incompatible goal, there is a struggle between the opposing forces. Duita individual ko bhitre bhi conflict hai pare. Di jan ho chandi opposing to each other, right? So there is another condition also. And what is that condition? Now, in the absence of a collaborative problem solving mechanism, then conflict hava pai duita jinsa darkar. Prathama jinsa kona na incompatible goal, and there is a struggle between the opposing forces or opposing parties, and there is no collaborative problem solving mechanism. If all these grounds or situations are there, then conflict may happen. So conflict, as I said, it is normal part of human life, it is normal part of societal life, and it is also normal part of international relation. So if it is not managed properly, now this conflict may turn into violence and may cause mass destruction. To effectively and efficiently controlling conflict and maintaining peace, there is a need for a deeper understanding of conflict. Now, what is that deeper understanding of conflict, right? Conflict can be various types, as I said earlier. So from the state perspective, or from the state side, if you see, there are two kinds of conflict. One is intrastate conflict. The other is interstate conflict. What is intrastate conflict? If a conflict happens within the state, then it is an intrastate conflict. What is an interstate conflict? If a conflict happens between the states, then it is an interstate conflict. The quality of interstate conflict is different from intrastate conflict. The interstate conflict or intrastate conflict, ei dui jan ko bhitare qualitative difference ache. Na kono na interstate conflict is more serious. That means you as an individual, you cannot solve it, or you are not the right person to handle with that. It is the government that has the power to control the interstate conflict. The state is given that power and authority or responsibility to do that. And it is serious because individuals are going to be affected seriously, I mean deeply, that they're going to be affected. If the state do something wrong, then the individuals within the state, they are going to pay the price. And that's why interstate conflict is serious. On the other hand, intrastate conflict, it is more frequent. Intrastate conflict kahinki frequently hue? Because it is non-serious. So what is serious, it doesn't happen frequently. And what happens frequently, that is not serious. So within the state, within the state, when there is conflict, then that conflict is manageable. That conflict is very much normal. That conflict is very much natural. And that's why it is frequent. That is one way of differentiating between the interstate conflict and intrastate conflict. There is the, what are the other differentiating between these two? That interstate conflict, it remains without the organized control. That means when there is an interstate conflict between the states, then society don't have any role to play. There is no organized control over interstate conflict. The state is the only agency to control it. In contrast to it, in the intrastate conflict, you will find that there is a organized controlling machinery. There is society. There is family. There is non-legal forces. There are social forces. They can deal with this conflict. That is the second way of distinguishing interstate conflict and intrastate conflict. The third way of distinguishing between the interstate conflict and intrastate conflict is that interstate conflict is more, threatening to the society, and intrastate conflict is much more individual in nature. That means if there is a war between two states, here I am using state as a nation state, if there is a war between the India and Pakistan, then the common individual of both the country, their life, their livelihood gets threatened. In the intrastate conflict, you will find such threatening are absent. These conflicts are much more individual in nature. So besides this, interstate conflict and intrastate conflict, there is intra-societal conflict. Society bhitre bhi, conflict chalita. Now, intra-societal conflict, it is the result of interpersonal conflict, and which is further caused by the intrapersonal conflict. Tike complex rahuchi. First conflict begins within the individual. Conflict happens within the individual. Then that conflict happens between the individual. After that, the conflict gets a social form and the conflict becomes intra-societal. And further, that intra-societal conflict, it may lead to inter-societal conflict. And the inter-societal conflict, it may lead to intrastate conflict within the state. And the intrastate conflict may lead to interstate conflict. So that's the actually, the sequence. The conflict actually individual pakharu start hochi, then it is moving upward. Tanu conflict ta sadabale individual mane adu upur ku jai na thai, upur adu bhi individual parjanta bhi asthai. There is a down to top approach and top to down approach also. So this intra-societal conflict, it is the result of interpersonal conflict. And this interpersonal conflict, it is caused by the intrapersonal conflict. And what is intrapersonal conflict? A conflict that goes within the individual. The I think this is right and that is wrong. If that is wrong, then I will not accept it. The moment I begin to think and begin to act on that regard, then I am entering to the conflictual zone. I am having conflict with other. I am having conflict with a person who is opposed to my understanding, opposed to my view. And when the interpersonal conflict, it goes to the next level, it takes certain, social issues or problems attached to it, it becomes an intra-societal conflict. So interpersonal conflict occurs with the class of human nature when individuals enter into human relationship. That means a interpersonal conflict ta kemti start hochi, now when two individuals are interacting, when two individuals are getting related to each other, then this interpersonal conflict it begins. This relationship and interaction is this relationship or interaction is related to sharing of available resources like food, water, property, etc. Tanu a conflict ta kahi ke hochi na conflict ta hochi human relation lo, human interaction lo. A human relation or interaction ko jinsa upare hei thai na eta hei thai relating to the available resources. There is a scarcity of resources. Our resources is minimum. So how to accumulate that resources? That actually the beginning of conflict. So inequality in access to resources, and when I'm saying resources, it is both material and non-material resources, may be the real or perceived, but it causes and provokes the human nature towards conflict. Tenu conflict ta kahin ke hochi na, there are few resources, there is a scarcity in the resources, and individuals are trying to accumulate resources and making their private property, right? So in that process, certain inequalities or issue of inequality that comes to in front of us, and that inequality, it may be the real inequality or it may be the perceived inequality. Real inequality kon na satare, there is a inequality. Perceived inequality means kon, it's a imaginary inequality. That means there is no such inequality, there is no inequality as such, but some group, they are thinking that they are being discriminated and they are strategically being made poor and unequal. So in both the cases, whether inequality is real or inequality is perceived or imaginary, inequality, it causes and provokes the human nature towards the conflict. Tamane, that is something which is innate to our human nature. That quality which is innate to the human nature, that is very much conducive to conflict when such a situation, such inequality, either real or perceived, it comes before the individual. And this conflict pervades from interpersonal conflict to intra-societal conflict to inter-societal conflict. तमने जो कन्फ्लिक्ट आरंभ हैला इंडिविजुअल मन के भीतर जो इंटरपर्सनल लेवल ले जो कन्फ्लिक्ट आरंभ हैला टेकिंग इनटू द प्रॉपर्टी टेकिंग इनटू इनइक्वालिटी राइट सेम पर्सनल कन्फ्लिक्ट सब्सिक्वेंट पीरियड रे इट टर्न्स इनटू इंट्रा सोसाइटल कन्फ्लिक्ट राइट इंट्रा सोसाइटल मीन्स विद इन द सोसाइटी नाउ टू ग्रुप्स दुईटा ग्रुप एमर्ज करुछंती प्रत्येक ग्रुप भितरे तांकर गोटे प्रकार रो सॉलिडारिटी रहुची एंड टू ग्रुप्स दे आर हैविंग कॉन्फ्लिक्ट विथ ईच अदर राइट एंड व्हेन सच इंट्रा सोसाइटल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट हैपेंस इट मे फर्दर लीड्स टू द इंटर सोसाइटल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट दैट मीन्स फॉर एग्जांपल गोटे एग्जांपल नबा सपोज गोटे गाँव भितर गोटे हेव गोटे ग्रुप हो गले हेव नॉट गोटे ग्रुप हो गले तनो आमे कहि परबा द कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बिटवीन द हेव एंड हेव नॉट विदिन दैट विलेज इज ए इंट्रा सोसाइटल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बट व्हेन इट बिकम्स इंटर सोसाइटल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट नाउ व्हेन ऑल द हेव्स इन द वर्ल्ड एंड ऑल द हेव नॉट्स इन द वर्ल्ड दे गॉट यूनाइटेड एंड दे ट्राई टू कॉन्फ्लिक्ट विथ ईच अदर देन it becomes a inter-societal. There are two society, have society and have not society. So this interpersonal conflict mostly escalate from the claims to property to violent quarrels. And violent quarrels sometimes leads to criminal offense. Further, the criminal offense is justified because of unequal access to resources. As a result, conflicts assume sharper dimensions and becomes intra-societal tension. So how the conflict becomes intra-societal? Now, mainly the and why the property is the main reason of interpersonal relationship. And when property becomes the main reason, then it may lead to violent quarrels. It may lead to criminal offense. In Baleshwar, there is a place called Uttar Balsar, right? There you can find a lots of fight between the brothers for their property. You know, one brother kills to another brother to own the property. And the person who kills the brother, he always justifies that he is the victim. And the victim killed the aggressor. You will find such a narration in Uttar Pradesh, right? In our district. And this property leads to the criminal offense, and subsequently the criminal offense gets justified. Je crime karuchi jodi taku patra de ki tame kahi ki marla, he may reply that I am the victim, the person was not giving my land to me, I have also equal share over my parental property. So they say je ma bhai jaha ko marli se seta ku jabar dakhal kar ki rakhta se mate ma property tu vanchita kariba pai chauntila se sada bale gote you know gote prakar justification dabo kona na ta prati anyay heiche ta prati gote gote inequality gote injustice ta prati heiche, right? So when such notion mane kona na jetale inequality injustice got attached to the conflict, then that interpersonal conflict converts into intra-societal conflict. Kebala eta Rama au Shyama bhitre dekha jauni, Hari au Madhava bhitre beta dekha jauchi, eta dekha hauchi pratyek ghara bhitre ei prakar ra gote situation dekha jauchi. Tenu e conflict ta Rama Shyama bhitre nu, jodi eta Rama Shyama bhitre start hela, but Rama Shyama case ra ଆମେ ଯାହା ବି କିଛି ଷ୍ଟଡି କଲୁ ସେଟା ଦେଖାହେଲା ହରି ମାଧବ ଅନ୍ୟମାନଙ୍କ ଲାଇଫରେ ବି ସମାନ ସମାନ ଷ୍ଟୋରି ସମାନ କଥା ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ସ ହାଉ ଇଟ୍ ବିକମ୍ ଇଣ୍ଟ୍ରା ସୋସାଇଟାଲ ୱିଦିନ୍ ଦି ସୋସାଇଟି ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍ ନା କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଆଟ୍ ଫ୍ୟାମିଲି ଅର୍ ଡୋମେଷ୍ଟିକ୍ ଲେବଲ୍ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ବି ମ୍ୟାନେଜଡ୍ ଅର୍ ରିଜଲ୍ଭ ୱିଥ୍ ଦି ଇଣ୍ଟରଭେନ୍ସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏଲ୍ଡର୍ସ ଅର୍ ରିଲେଟିଭ୍ ଯେଉଁଟା ମୁଁ ପୂର୍ବରୁ କହିଲି while I was distinguishing between the interstate conflict and intrastate conflict, I mentioned, if you remember, that intrastate conflict, it remains under organized control. And who are these organizing forces? These organizing forces are the elders, are the relative. Jatala family level le kaunsi conflict hauchi ta satebale taku samadhan kariba pai amaro jo mane amatharu bada ଆଉ ଯେଉଁମାନେ ଆମର ସମ୍ପର୍କୀୟ ତ ସେମାନେ ୟୁନୋ ଆସିକି ୟୁନୋ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟକୁ ସେମାନେ ସଲ୍ଭ କରିଥାନ୍ତି ବଟ୍ ୱେନ୍ ଡିସ୍ପ୍ୟୁଟ୍ସ ବିକମ୍ସ ଇଣ୍ଟେନ୍ସ ବଟ୍ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଡିସ୍ପ୍ୟୁଟ୍ଟା ଇଣ୍ଟେନ୍ସ ହେଇଯାଏ ଫର୍ ଏକ୍ଜାମ୍ପଲ୍ ଫ୍ୟାମିଲି କଳହ ଭିତରେ ଜଣେ ଜଣକୁ ମାରିଦେଉଛି ସ୍ୱାମୀ ସ୍ତ୍ରୀ ଝଗଡ଼ା ଭିତରେ ସ୍ତ୍ରୀଟେ ସ୍ୱାମୀକୁ ମାରିଦେଲା ବା ସ୍ୱାମୀଟେ ସ୍ତ୍ରୀକୁ ମାରିଦେଲା ଦୁଇ ଭାଇଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ଝଗଡ଼ା ବେଳେ ଜଣେ ଭାଇ ଆଉ ଜଣେ ଭାଇକୁ ମାରିଦେଲା ବାପ ପୁଅ ଝଗଡ଼ା ଭିତରେ ଜଣେ ଆଉ ଜଣକୁ ମାରିଦେଲା ମାରିଦେଲା ମାନେ କ'ଣ ନା ଯେତେବେଳେ କ୍ରାଇମ୍ ବା କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟଟା ଗୋଟେ ଇଣ୍ଟେନ୍ସ ସ୍ତରକୁ ପଳେଇଯାଏ ନା ସେତେବେଳେ ଦ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଇଣ୍ଟରଭିନ୍ସ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ସେଇଠି ଇଣ୍ଟରଭିନ୍ କରେ କାହିଁକି ନା ସେଟା ସବୁ ଲ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଅର୍ଡର୍ ସେଟା ପୋଲିସର ଏନ ପରଭ୍ୟୁକୁ ସେଟା ପଳେଇ ଆସେ ତେଣୁ ଦୁଇଟା କାରଣ ପାଇଁ ଏଠି ଆସିଥାଏ ଗୋଟେ ତ ମୁଁ କହିଲି ନା ଯେତେବେଳେ କ୍ରାଇମ୍ଟା ଇଣ୍ଟେନ୍ସ ହେଇଯାଏ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟଟା ଇଣ୍ଟେନ୍ସ ହେଇଯାଏ ନା ସେତେବେଳେ ଆଉ ଏଲ୍ଡର୍ ଆଉ ରିଲେଟିଭ୍ସ ମାନେ ଏ କେସ୍କୁ ସଲ୍ଭ କରିପାରନ୍ତିନି ସେତେବେଳେ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆସିବା ୟୁନୋ ଇଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ ବିକମ୍ସ ଏ ଇମ୍ପାରେଟିଭ୍ ଆଇ ମିନ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ହେଜ୍ ଟୁ କମ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଡିଲ୍ ୱିଥ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଟେକ୍ ଦି କଣ୍ଟ୍ରୋଲ୍ ଓଭର୍ ଦି ସିଚୁଏସନ୍ ରାଇଟ୍ ବଟ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ଏନଦର୍ ରିଜିନ୍ କି ୱାଇ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ କମ୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଣ୍ଟରଭିନ୍ Now, when elders and relatives become passive, suppose you get a conflict, जोंटा को एल्डर्स और रिलेटिव्स माने सॉल्व करी परिवे बट ड्यू टू देयर मैटेरियलिस्टिक लाइफ ड्यू टू देयर सेल्फिश इंटरेस्ट ड्यू टू देयर यू नो ऑटोमिस्ट लाइफस्टाइल दे डोंट दे आर लिस्ट बदर अबाउट यू दे डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू इन्वॉल्व इन योर केस एंड दे प्रिफर टू बिकम पैसिव इन दैट टाइम ऑल्सो वेन एल्डर्स एंड रिलेटिव्स दे बिकम पैसिव देन ऑल्सो द स्टेट आई मीन इंटरवीन्स एंड इट बिकम्स इम्पेरेटिव फॉर द स्टेट टू 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 इंटरवीन एंड वेन स्टेट इंटरवीन तो बेसिकली मीन्स द जुडिशियल और लीगल सिस्टम ऑफ द स्टेट बिकम्स द मेकानिजम फॉर कॉन्फ्लिक्ट रिजोल्यूशन तेणु जिते पुलिस आसर्ट कचेरी ये सब जिन आसो डर कथा नुह बट ऑल दिस आर द स्टेट अपैरेटस ऑफ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट रिजोल्यूशन और कॉन्फ्लिक्ट मैनेजमेंट पुलिस आसला कौन पाई पुलिस को डर कथा नुह पुलिस आसला केस को समाधान करने जो समाधानटा फैमिली रिलेटिव्स माने करि पारलेनी आउ जते बेले इंटेंसिटी ऑफ द क्राइम और कॉन्फ्लिक्ट इट बिकम शार्पन एट दैट टाइम स्टेट कम विथ इट्स लीगल एंड जुडिशियल सिस्टम एंड दिस सिस्टम ऑफ स्टेट इट इज द मेकानिज्म फॉर द कॉन्फ्लिक्ट रिजोल्यूशन And the law itself is the combination of custom and tradition with the codified law. So, so there is a social component of override. The sentiments of the social sentiments of the individual, right? So generally, justice. Is always pro people. It is not anti people. Justice is not anti society. Justice is always pro society. Otherwise, the society will not obey the justice or decision. Right. So, if you see closely the nature of law, you will find that there are two components of law. One is the custom and tradition, and the other is. The codified law. So you can find there is a rational legal authority, and you can also find there is you know traditional legitimacy. Jota ame kahuche Weberian sense re. If you understand that our law there is though traditional legal legitimacy. But there is the custom or tradition is also inherent in that law. So as I said, the property is the main cause of the intra-societal conflict, and this cause has been referred by Rousseau in his work The Social Contract. And in that book, he says that the person who fixed poles and around a piece of land and calls it his own is the prime originator of social conflict jata Rousseau social contract re kon kahuchanti na actually gote property ku mu bada gheri deli then I try to claim that is my property now that's the beginning or that individual is the originator of the social conflict ta mane kon if there is no property then there is no conflict right so in a sense also Rousseau jonta kahunahanti there is another philosopher is Proudhon Proudhon kon kahuchanti na property is theft that means property belongs to the nature this is also a tribal concept of property property belongs to the nature if property jodi bhagwan kara property jodi prakriti ra then how come you are saying that you are the owner of that property when you yourself is not owning your body I mean one day you will disappear from this world So what you call your property that is actually a theft property, setaku tumi chori koricho, that is not yours, that is based on certain kind of manipulation, right? So this is the understanding of prudhan. Se got a step aguku palele roso tharo, se kale property is theft, right? So besides property, there are also other important causes of conflict, such as property ku chadi salla pare au kichhi bhi conflict ro karan achi. For example, our diverse identity, then the appeasement policy of the state, right? And the third, authoritative allocation of values. So how diverse identity is the main cause of the conflict. Now, in the public, for its existence, for its progress in the future, and each and every identity is very much diverse from each other. So if we are diverse, then obviously it will lead to the conflict. We are not same, we are different. And in the public place, we want we try to assert our demand in the public for accumulating the wealth, accumulating the position, right? So this diversity of or the diverse based identity, it is another cause of conflict. Then there is appeasement policy of the state. Now, appeasement policy of the state means what? What is appeasement policy? Appeasement policy is a policy of not solving a problem, rather than satisfying the aggrieved parties. Appease kariba anya ko. Ta mane kon gote teacher te jo pila te tare bhalo lekhu nahi gote teacher te hello jo pila te khatare lekhu nahi gote teacher te gote pila gote pila te khatare kichi lekhu ni gote teacher ta ko kon karuchi na ta ko zero dauni ta ko dor laguchi tenu se kon karuchi na se pila ko tike adhika mark dei dauchi. So sethi bhi mu kahibi the teacher is following a kind of appeasement, because maybe tara teacher je headmaster ba tar je principal achi se hue to kale question put kari pare ki apan kemti kon padhau chanti kahi ki pila fail kale ba kahi ki kom number rakhu chanti hue to teacher pakharu ba headmaster ba principal pakharu se katha na suniba pai se gote pila ko se mark dei dau chi. आ जतबे से पिलाट को से मार्क दे दोचे सतबेले तर हेडमास्टर बा प्रिंसिपल ताको किछि कथा कहुनी आ से पिला भी खुशी हे जाउचे बट लॉन्ग टर्म रे से पिलार भविष्यत खराब हे जाउचे. तो समवेयर इन दैट सिचुएशन आल्सो द स्टेट और द टीचर ट्राइज टू एपीज बोथ द स्टूडेंट एंड एपीज टू द प्रिंसिपल और द हेडमास्टर. So gote teacher ro jemti example ta mu deli sei bhalia gote 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 state madhya sie bi tar appeasement policy follow kari thae. Remember the Congress appeasement policy towards minority, and remember the appeasement policy of Rajiv Gandhi towards the majority community related to the Ram Mandir or Ram Janmabhoomi issue. I remember the majority appeasement policy played by the BJP, the way Congress criticized BJP. BJP till now it has not given a very clear answer to their criticism, right? So this appeasement policy is also another reason that conflict happens. Mostly tumhe dekhibo Hindu aur Islam ba Muslim man India bhitre jo Hindu aur Muslim man ko bhitre jo conflict hai tha. Mostly it is related to the appeasement policy of the state. Then the third is the authoritative allocation of the value. Authoritative allocation of the value means basically it is the distribution of resources. Could the state is properly distributing resources or not? We have to see whether the rich is becoming richer or the poor is becoming poorer, right? So if there is an improper distribution of wealth, then obviously there will be emergence of different groups, aggrieved groups. And those aggrieved groups, they become the part of that conflict. So to deal with the intra-societal and intra-state conflict, the state has a wide infrastructural network from executive branch to judicial branch. So our three branch rahile state re, executive, legislature and judiciary, mostly tinta jaka branch, they try to normalize the conflict. The conflict, interpersonal conflict, intra-societal conflict, inter-societal conflict, intra-state conflict, interstate conflict. Basically, three branches of the government, they try to, resolve the conflict and they try to become the agency of conflict management, right? So executive police re ame executive branch re kon dekho na, in the executive branch you will find the police are its are its monopoly sub agent. Jodi ame dekhiba ki conflict uda me mostly society bhitare jo conflict hochi, mostly sabu police taku deal karuchi. You can feel the manifestation of state. You can see police as the manifestation of the executive branch of the state. So besides police, you can find the civil servant. They are also playing their role in the overall supervision. For example, you can take the amar jo COVID-19 la jo Odisha ra je mukhapatra spokesperson Subrat Bagchi, is a civil servant, right? Now he is also having the supervision duty over COVID-19, right? So this is also a kind of, the supervision itself is a conflict management, right? Conflict management kahe ki, now how smoothly conduct how smoothly individual should behave, individual should regulate their conduct so that COVID-19 etematre amko affect koribo nahi, right? So these are the significance of supervisory or significance of supervision so far as the executive role over conflict management is concerned. So there is legislative branch. This legislative branch, as we all know, that it creates laws. And what is the significance of the laws? Now these laws are to curtail, are to reduce, are to avoid the conflict. Ame jaha bhi kichhi rules tiyari korchu, e rules kuda conflict ko address kariba pai, conflict ko reduce kariba pai, problem ro solution aniba pai. That is the main purpose of the law, and the legislature tries to make the law. Legislature's law kahi ki tiyari karuchi, kebal conflict ko management kariba pai law che tiyari karuchi. Then there is judicial branch, jo ta ame directly dekhuche ki actually amaro jaha bhi kichhi conflict hochi, at the end it comes to the judiciary, court ko, police court ko forward kar douchi. Now it is the judiciary that tries to see that who is guilty and who is not. It is the judiciary who puts a full stop to the conflict by giving punishment or by giving a order for a compensation. Basically, judiciary gives a full stop to the conflict. So when all these branches fail to do their function in resolving the conflict, if there is failure of police, if the rules are not solving the problem, ending the conflict, rather than the rules are creating the conflict, and when judiciary fails to identify who is right and who is wrong, when the judiciary gets politicized, in that situation, all these three branches of the state, it fails to resolve the conflict, then that state becomes a failed state. Very often ame media re dekho bibhinna issue asi jae asiki tapare intellectual mane argument karanti, is India having a failed state? Is Indian state has failed? So if you say it is India is having a failed state, then you become extreme, right? Are you indirectly or directly saying that executive branch, there are no honest person in the executive branch, there are no honest person in the legislative branch, there is no honest person in the judicial branch? Are you saying so? If it is not, then it's very much difficult to say that Indian state is a failed state. So in the past, the failed state attracted intervention. So theoretically, at least, ame kahi pariba what is a failed state. Na jetebale ei tini prakar ra branch jo state re achi, if they fail to maintain peace, they fail to resolve the conflict, then the state becomes a failed state. And when there is a failure of the state, then there is always an external aggression over that state. So in the past, the failed state attracted intervention usually from a relatively powerful neighbor. If Indian state will be failed, then obviously the China may attack us, right? So the failure of the state, it is not a good symbol for the existence of the state in the international arena, right? Jatobale ame kahiba jatobale gruha juddha chalithae gote desha bhitare gruha juddha chalithae sei tai upajukta samay thae gote external aggressor pai se desha ku nijara aktiyar ku se nei jai thae, right? So if one go to the deeper analysis, then one may find that the perpetrator of intra-societal conflicts are the main reasons for the failed state. Now kahin ki executive ba legislature ba judiciary se mane kahin ki conflict ko resolve kari paru nahanti, se mane kahin ki peace ko maintain kari paru nahanti, jadi tumhe deeper analysis ko jiba, you may find that there are perpetrator of intra-societal conflict. Society bhitare jo gruha juddha laguchi, intra-societal jo conflict rahuchi, a conflict naturally no ar kehi jane perpetrator achi, kehi jane aku nepathyare chalouchi, right? Ta nijare kichi vested interest achi, and that perpetrator is main reason for this failed state. Maybe state jodi, if the state will fail, then maybe the perpetrator is going to gain some power, right? Some wealth, some resources. So when we say failed state, it basically means there is an administrative failure of the state over its people and society. Now state in such a situation can be retrieved with the help of civil society. ना जत बले स्टेटटा गोटे फेल स्टेट रे परिणत हो कनवर्ट हो जाऊँ ना से स्टेटटा पुणी यू नो रिट्राइव करी परिबो केते बले ना इफ सिविल सोसाइटी विल 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 हेल्प इफ सिविल सोसाइटी विल इंटरवीन ना सिविल सोसाइटी इट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द स्टेट बट मेनी टाइम्स इट डज द फंक्शन ऑफ द स्टेट एंड व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ द स्टेट ना कंसेंसस बिल्डिंग. Now civil society generate the consensus within the society between individual, right? So jetebale gruha juddha laguchi to setebale civil society ro role bahut important hochi, setebale civil society सतले सिविल सोसाइटी इट कम्स इनटू पिक्चर एंड ट्राइज टू बिल्ड अप कंसेंसस विद इन द इंडिविजुअल And when the consensus is built, then the trust over the state can be generated, and the state will continues to exist for the sake of individual. I mean, lokomane puni you know state ko vishwas kariba arambha karidiyant, right? Then when the responsibility are fulfilled by a bodies of outside the state, then we speak of a strong civil society. Now, in a failed state, when civil society becomes successful in building the consensus, then we call that there is a strong civil society in the state. Right? So, ame jemti kahi parche, in a failed state, the civil society can be strong. Semiti ame gote strong state ko bhi define kari pariba. What is a strong state? Now, if the government intervenes in the civil society, then we speak of strong state. Right? So, if the state is strong, then there is no need of civil society. If the state is strong, then there is no need of civil society. Because state knows how to intervene, why to intervene, where to intervene, but state is clear that the intervention is related with the welfare of the citizen. So if there is a strong state, then the strong state can intervene for the good life of individual. But when the state is a failed state, then there is a possibility for the civil society to become a strong civil society, and it helps the state to retrieve itself. Now let's come to the interstate conflict, right? Interstate conflict, as I said earlier, it is a conflict between the states. And in the political science, state means jonta ka me koiba Odisha ko bhi gote state kouche, Bharat ko center kouche, but India is also a state. In political science, all these concepts, they don't have one meaning, it has multiple meaning. So here when I'm saying interstate conflict, then I'm saying that it is a conflict between the India, for example, India and Pakistan. India as a state, Pakistan as a state, right? In that sense, try to understand this interstate conflict. So when there is an interstate conflict, then it may give rise to war. As the interstate conflict aram hochi, satavale tara solution da kebolo war rehi rahuchi, right? Jodiyo, though not all interstate conflict may result in war. Jodiyo sabu interstate conflict it doesn't lead to the war, but still then war may arise with the interstate conflict, right? Judhya hai jai, interstate conflict hai le judhya hai jai. And politics is the method of dealing with interstate conflict. Politics is conducted through a diplomacy, right? So jatale interstate conflict hochi satabale the possibility of war pali aschi, to jatale possibility of war aschi satabale you know politics you know it becomes a method of dealing the interstate conflict. Politics mane kon? Politics mane here we understand democracy, party politics, right? Prime ministerial form of government, not the presidential form of government, right? It's not you know presidential rule. So the possibility of war will be much more higher in a presidential form of government than in a you know democratic or prime ministerial form of government. Prime ministerial form of government re the possibility of war tike kam thai. They use negotiation and they use diplomacy to avoid the war. So there is a dialectical relation between the war and diplomacy. Now when diplomacy fails, war begins. And when war begins, diplomacy becomes the necessity. And there are some scholars who see war as a part of diplomacy. Now, a war of diplomacy kona na jetebale diplomacy kamo kare ni setebale war arambh hoi jae a jetebale war arambh hoi jae setebale ame feel karu mane diplomacy must be there karan war leads to destruction and diplomacy leads to peaceful existence, diplomacy leads to life. But there are also scholars, they think that war is a part of diplomacy. तमाने कहाँ को युद्धर धमक दबाटा भी गोटे डिप्लोमेसी पार्ट युद्धर धमक दबा गोटे वीकर स्टेट को युद्धर धमक दबा युद्धर धमक दबाटा भी गोटे डिप्लोमेसी पार्ट टू सम स्कॉलर्स एंड वार इज एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ नेशनल पॉलिसी इट इज यूज्ड बाय स्टेट to achieve national goal and fulfill national interest. Now, war. War is related with national interest. War is related with national power, right? And the question of war and peace are central to the understanding of IR. Then international relation le you know you need to have a very you know diplomatic understanding over this peace and conflict, over this war and diplomacy, right? Whether war is a part of diplomacy or not, and where diplomacy must begin and where diplomacy must end. So you need a very you know critical look on this matter. So these questions involve the problem of the survival, right? So in the international relation also, we avoid war and we try to maintain peace, and the main reason is the survival. We all have the nuclear weapon, and we know that I am right, you are wrong. India is right, Pakistan is wrong, or Pakistan is right, India is wrong. In such a situation, na gote chotto chinkari bi duita desh ko nashta kar di pare, right? So peace in the international relation, it is a matter of survival. It is not a matter of justice, right? If you think that most ita injustice kara jaichi and I have the power, I will apply my power, then the other person can also do the same, and both the person or both the state, it will perish. And when both perish, then justice kahan paye, right? So peace is not, in the international relation, peace is not based on justice. Peace is based on survival. So we speak of Cold War, we speak of Hot War, we speak of limited war, total war, conventional war, and unconventional war, civil war, guerrilla war, preventive war, etc. There are so many wars. And there has been repeated recurrence of war in the world over the past several centuries. And in 1968, the historian named Will Duranto, he calculated that there has been only 268 years free from war in the previous 3,421 years. So, bigot 3,421 barsa bhitre kebal 268 ta barsa we are free from the war. Kebal 268 ko jodi me subtract kar dabo, tebe 3,421 barsa ru paka paki 3,100 barsa. We are at the war, and we have done enough destruction. So today the spectrum of war has expanded from traditional military dimension to political and economic warfare, psychological warfare, right? To ame ei jo corona ko nei ki bhi আমি বেলে বেলে ভাবো ইট ইজ এ ওয়ার বাই দি চাইনা এগেনস্ট দি ওয়ার্ল্ড, ইট ইজ এ ওয়ার বাই ইউজিং হোয়াট ইট কল বায়োপলিটিক্স, ইট ইজ এ ওয়ার অফ ইউজিং বায়োপলিটিক্স, রাইট? সো আজিকার টাইমে আমি ওয়ারকে কেবল মিলিটারি ওয়ার বা আমি তাকে এটমিক ওয়ার রূপে আমি ভাবুনে, আমি কহুছে ওয়ার বি ইকোনোমিক স্পিয়র বি চালি পারিব, জনকু আমি ইকোনোমিক্যালি উইক বি করি পারিব, রাইট? জনকু আমি সাইকোলজিক্যাল সাইকোলজিক্যালি বি আমি জনকু উইক করাই পারিব। সো টু ডিফাইন ওয়ার, দ্য আমেরিকান পলিটিক্যাল সাইন্স ডিফাইনিং দি ওয়ার, টু হিম ওয়ার ইজ এ ওয়েস্ট on the diplomatic, economic and propaganda fronts as well as the military fronts, and that art of war coordinates all those elements to the purpose of victory. In a narrow sense, war is confined to military aspect. Tanu Quincy Wright bhi sei kotha kahuchanti ki but traditional sense re ba narrow sense re ame war ku gote military aspect sahita ame taku jodu বা ওয়ারকে আমি গোটে মিলিটারি ওয়ে আমি ওয়ারকে ডিফাইন করু, বট মডর্ন ওয়ার গুড়া ডিপ্লোমাটিক লেভেলে মডর্ন ওয়ার করা যাই থাকে, ইকোনোমিক লেভেলে মডর্ন ওয়ার করা যাই থাকে, প্রপাগান্ডা লেভেলে বি মডর্ন ওয়ার গুড়া করা যাই থাকে, এন্ড দ্য মেইন পারপোজ অফ দি ওয়ার ইজ টু বিকম দি ইজ টু গেট দি ভিক্টরি। না কেবল কনভেনশনাল কেবল মিলিটারি ওয়ে আমি ভিক্টরি হবু তার কিছু মানে, ইটস নট নেসেসারিলি দ্যাটস দ্য অনলি ওয়ে টু বিকম ইউনো টু গেট দ্যাট টু গেট ভিক্টরি বাই ইউজিং দি মিলিটারি পাওয়ার, ইউ ক্যান অলসো গেন দি ভিক্টরি থ্রু ডিপ্লোমেটসি, যেমনি নরেন্দ্র মোদী পাকিস্তান এগেনস্টে আমি কেমতি ডিপ্লোমাটিক স্টেপ গুড়া নেইছু, তুমি সেটা চিন্তা করলে বি ইউ ক্যান গেট দি সেন্স, রাইট? দ্যার আর অলসো ইকোনোমিক কনস্ট্রেন্টস, গোটে দেশকে ইকোনোমিক্যালি উইক করেদেলে বি ইউ বিকম দি ইউ ইউ মে গেট দি ভিক্টরি। সো দ্যার হ্যাজ বিন নো কনসেনসাস সো ফার ইজ অ্যানালাইজিং কজেস অফ ওয়ার ইজ কনসার্ন, সম কজেস আর ইমিডিয়েট, সম কজেস আর বেসিক, সম কজেস আর আইডিওলজিক্যাল, সম কজেস রিলেটেড টু দি অ্যাক্ট অফ কমিশন by different countries, etc. And each of the causes needs to be explored, and there can be no final answer to the question of what causes the or what are the causes of war. So that there may be different causes of war. Remember the First World War. First World War kahi ke hitila? Generally gota prashna pade pratham vishwajuddha kahi ke hitila? You will find that there is a immediate cause, there is a basic cause, there is an ideological cause. Seiti pai prathama bishwajuddha heithila. Tenu jetebele konosi war ghotuchi se war re multiple causes thai pare, immediate cause bi thai pare, the prime cause or the joda hocho basic cause seta thai pare, ideological cause thai pare, right? So each of these causes need to be explored, and there can be no final answer to the question of what is the cause of the war. There can be different causes of war. So generally the cause of war are classified under political, economic, social, psychological causes, and the Quincy Wright, the American political scientist, he classified war into four category. The first is the politico-technological war, then the second is the you know juro ideological war, then third is the socio religious war, and the fourth is the you know psycho economics economics war. Tanu ame e jo politico technological war ko ame kon bujhibu na, when there is the use of technology to defeat the other state, jo ta ame kahi pariba e jo paramanu boma, রাইট? এই যে আমার গোটে প্রকার ମୋ ପାଖରେ କେତେ ପରମାଣୁ ଅସ୍ତ୍ର ଅଛି, ମୋ ପାଖରେ ମୋର ଟେକ୍ନୋଲୋଜି କେତେ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରଙ୍ଗ ଅଛି। ସୋ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ମେକ୍ ୟୋର ଟେକ୍ନୋଲୋଜି ଭେରି ଷ୍ଟ୍ରଙ୍ଗ, ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ହେଭିଂ ଏ ବେଟର ଏଜ୍ ଓଭର ୟୋର ଏନିମି, ତ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ମେ ଏଣ୍ଡ। ସୋ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ବିକମ୍ ସୁପର ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍, ଦେନ୍ ୟୋର ଏନିମି ମେ ନଟ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ଗେଟ୍, ମାନେ ସାହସ ପାଇବନି ତୁମ ସହିତ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ କରାଇବା ପାଇଁ। ସୋ ଟେକ୍ନୋଲୋଜିକାଲ ଆଡ଼ଭାନ୍ସମେଣ୍ଟ ଦ୍ୱାରା ବି ୟୁ ନୋ ୱାର୍କୁ ଡିଲ୍ କରାଯାଇପାରେ। ଦେନ୍ ଦି ଆଇଡ଼ିଓଲୋଜିକାଲ ଲେବୁଲରେ ବି ୟୁ ନୋ ୱାର୍ ହେଇଥାଏ। ଫର ଏକ୍ଜାମ୍ପଲ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲିଜିମ୍ ଭର୍ସେସ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିଜିମ୍, ଲିବରାଲିଜିମ୍ ଭର୍ସେସ୍ ମାର୍କ୍ସିଜିମ୍, ଦିସ୍ ୱାର୍ ଇଜ୍ ବେସିକାଲି ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଆଇଡ଼ିଓଲୋଜିକାଲ ୱାର୍। ଦେନ୍ ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ୱାର୍ ବେସ୍ଡ ଅନ୍ ଦି ସୋସିଓ ରିଲିଜିୟସ୍ ଆସ୍ପେକ୍ଟ। ଫର ଏକ୍ଜାମ୍ପଲ୍ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ଲୁକ୍ ଏଟ୍ ଦି ମିଡ଼ିଲ୍ ଇଷ୍ଟ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରିଜ୍, ଆରବିଆନ୍ ଆରବ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ସ, ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ମେ ଫାଇଣ୍ଡ ଦେଟ୍ ଦ ୱାର୍ ଇଜ୍ ରିଲେଟେଡ୍ ୱିଥ୍ ଦେୟାର ସୋସିଓ ରିଲିଜିୟସ୍ ଟ୍ରାଡିସନ୍ ଅର୍ ସୋସିଓ ରିଲିଜିୟସ୍ ଆସ୍ପେକ୍ଟ। ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ସାଇକୋ ଇକୋନୋମିକ୍ସ, ସାଇକୋ ଇକୋନୋମିକ୍ସ ମିନ୍ସ ଦ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ବିଟୱିନ୍ ଦି ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଚାଇନା। ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଚାଇନା ବୋଥ୍ ୱାଣ୍ଟ ଟୁ ବି ଦି ସୁପର ପାୱାର ଇନ୍ ଦି ସାଉଥ ଏସିଆନ୍ ରିଜିଅନ୍, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ କନ୍ଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ, କେବଳ ଜିଓଗ୍ରାଫିକୁ ନେଇକି ଚାଲିନି, ଇଭିନ୍ ଇକୋନୋମିକ୍ ସୁପର ପାୱାରକୁ ନେଇକି ବି ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ଚାଇନା ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଚାଲୁଛି। ସୋ ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ଦି ୟୁ ନୋ ଫୋର୍ ଫୋଲ୍ଡ କ୍ଲାସିଫିକେସନ୍ ବାଇ ଦି ବାଇ ଦି ଆମେରିକାନ୍ ପଲିଟିକାଲ ସାଇଣ୍ଟିଷ୍ଟ କ୍ୱିନ୍ସି ରାଇଟ୍, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଥ୍ରୀ ଲେବଲ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଏନାଲିସିସ୍ ଟୁ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡ ଦି କଜ୍ ଅଫ୍ ୱାର୍। ଫାର୍ଷ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଲେବଲ୍ କଜ୍, ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦିସ୍ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଲେବଲ୍ କଜ୍, ଆଣ୍ଡ ଥାର୍ଡ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ୍ ଲେବଲ୍ କଜ୍, ରାଇଟ୍? ତ ଆମେ ଏଠି କ'ଣ କରୁଛେ ନା, ଆମେ ଏଠି ଚିନ୍ତା କରୁଛେ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ କଜେସ୍ ଦି ୱାର୍, ୱାର୍ କାହିଁକି ହେଉଛି, କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ କାହିଁକି ହେଉଛି, କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ କେଉଁ କେଉଁ ଜିନିଷ ଉପରେ ହେଉଛି ଏବେ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ, ଆଉ ସେ ଟ୍ରାଡିସନାଲ୍ ବା ମିଲିଟାରୀ ଆସ୍ପେକ୍ଟରେ ୱାର୍ ହେଉନାହିଁ ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ। ୱାର୍ ତାର ୟୁ ନୋ ମିନିଂ, ନେଚର ସ୍କୋପ୍ ସବୁ ଚେଞ୍ଜ କରିଦେଇଛି, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଥ୍ରୀ ଲେବଲ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଏନାଲିସିସ୍ ଦ ସେଟ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଲେବଲ୍ କଜ୍, ମାନେ ହାଉ ଟୁ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡ ଦି କଜେସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ୱାର୍, ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ କଜେସ୍ ୱାର୍, ଏଇ ଏଇ ପ୍ରଶ୍ନର ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଥ୍ରୀ ଲେବଲ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଏନାଲିସିସ୍। ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଲେବଲ୍ ଏନାଲିସିସ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଲେବଲ୍ କଜ୍ କ'ଣ କହୁଛି ନା, ଦ ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଲ୍ ଆର୍ଗୁମେଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଆପ୍ରୋଚ୍, ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଲେବଲ୍ କଜ୍ ଆପ୍ରୋଚ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦେଟ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ନନ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆକ୍ଟର୍ସ ଅପରେଟ୍ ଇନ୍ ଏ ଗ୍ଲୋବାଲ୍ ସୋସିଆଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ କଲ୍ଚରାଲ୍, ଇକୋନୋମିକ୍, ପଲିଟିକାଲ୍, ଜିଓଗ୍ରାଫିକାଲ୍ ଏନ୍ଭାରମେଣ୍ଟ, ହ୍ୱେର୍ ଦ ଫିଚର୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଦିସ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଡିଟର୍ମାଇନ୍ ଦ ବିହେଭିୟର୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ଆକ୍ଟର୍, ରାଇଟ୍? ତ ସେ କହୁଛି ଦ୍ୟାର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍, ରାଇଟ୍? ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦେୟାର୍ ଇନ୍ ଦି ଇନ୍ ଦି ଇନ୍ ଦି ଗ୍ଲୋବାଲ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ଏରେନା, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦେୟାର୍ ଇନ୍ ଦି ଗ୍ଲୋବାଲ୍ ଏରେନା, ଦ୍ୟାର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ କଲ୍ଚର୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍, ଦ୍ୟାର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଇକୋନୋମି ଅଫ୍ ଦି ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍, ଦ୍ୟାର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଏନ୍ଭାରମେଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍। ନା ୱିଦିନ୍ ଦିସ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଅଲ୍ ଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ନନ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆକ୍ଟର୍ସ ଦେ ଆର୍ ବିଙ୍ଗ୍ ଗାଇଡେଡ୍। ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆକ୍ଟର୍ ଆମେ ନେବା ବିଭିନ୍ନ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ନେସନ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍, ଆଉ ନନ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆକ୍ଟର୍ ନେବା ବିଭିନ୍ନ ବିଭିନ୍ନ ଏନ୍ଜିଓସ୍। ସୋ ଅଲ୍ ଦି ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ନନ୍ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆକ୍ଟର୍ ଦେ ଅପରେଟ୍ ୱିଦିନ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଦିସ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍, ଏଣ୍ଡ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଗାଇଡେଡ୍ ବାଇ ଦି ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍। ଇଟ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ଦ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍, ଦ ଫିଚର୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଡିଟର୍ମାଇନ୍ ଦି ବିହେଭିୟର୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ଆକ୍ଟର୍ସ। ସୋ ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଫୋର୍ ଫ୍ୟାକ୍ଟର୍ସ ଦେଟ୍ ଡିଟର୍ମାଇନ୍ ହାଉ ଏ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଫଙ୍କସନ୍, ଆଣ୍ଡ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ଫୋର୍ ଫ୍ୟାକ୍ଟର୍ସ, ଦ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ଚରାଲ୍ କ୍ୟାରେକ୍ଟରିଷ୍ଟିକ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍, ଦ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ଦି ପାୱାର୍ ରିଲେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ମେମ୍ବର୍ସ ୱିଦିନ୍ ଦି ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍, ଥାର୍ଡ ଇକୋନୋମିକ୍ ରିଏଲିଟିଜ୍ ଦେଟ୍ ଇମ୍ପିଞ୍ଜ ଅପନ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍, ଦେନ୍ ଫୋର୍ଥ ନର୍ମସ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ କନ୍ଭେନ୍ସନ୍ ଦେଟ୍ ଗଭର୍ନ୍ସ ଦି ବିହେଭିୟର୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ଆକ୍ଟର୍ସ। ସୋ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ଚରାଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ କ୍ୟାରେକ୍ଟରିଷ୍ଟିକ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍? ଦ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ଚରାଲ୍ କ୍ୟାରେକ୍ଟରିଷ୍ଟିକ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ is nothing but organization of authority within the system, actors, and level of interaction between the them. That means there are authority within the system. Then authority system pakhre bhi power achi, individual man ko pakhre power achi, and there is interaction between the system and the individual that constitute the structural characteristic of a system. That means if you are working within a system, then you should know the power the system has. The power is you are part of that system. The power you are having, and you need to understand what kind of relationship it has been existed between the individual and the system. So overall, all these constitute the structural characteristic of a system. Then the second is the power relation power relations of members within the system. What is this power relation of members? Now this is nothing but the distribution of power. Who gets how much? Kie kete power ra adhikari achi? All are not equal so far as the power is concerned. Kaunasi bhi organization bhitare you will find there are different kinds of personnel, and different personnel they are having different power. So to work within this system, you must know that who holds how much power. Without that, you may not function within that system. Then there is economic realities. Now what are the economic realities of an system? The economic realities of a system is its natural resources, is its economic and industrial development. Now both these resources, natural resources, our economic or industrial development, both constitute the economic realities of a system. And the fourth one is the norms and conventions that governs the behavior of the system. So what is a convention? The rules that is being practiced since long, and it may not be in the written form, right? Sambalpur University re kaam kariba pai hele mate Sambalpur University ra jaha be kichi convention achi mate taku janiba pai padibo. Otherwise I may not understand. I may not play my role perfectly. Pratyek organization, pratyek system ra tar gute convention achi. Mangala grah ro gote lokate asiki prithibi prushtha ko jetala asiki se hatat e system ku se bujhi paribo nahi. ए सिस्टम को बुझिया पई हेले ताको किछि दिन एठी रहिबा पई पड़िबो ताको कन्वेंशन तार जो नॉर्म्स अछि ताको बुझिबा पई पड़िबो. सो दीज फोर आर द फैक्टर्स दैट हेल्प्स दैट्स हाउ ए सिस्टम फंक्शंस. सो एट सिस्टम लेवल एनालिसिस फॉलोइंग आर द कॉजेस ऑफ वॉर कौन ना अनइवन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ पावर दैट्स द फर्स्ट कॉज of war. Then the second, anarchical nature of the system. Anarchical nature of the system mane kono na ame jo world system kahuche, world system, a world system re there is no authority. Jemti ki India bhitre gote supreme court achi au supreme court ku maniba mane we all are bound to obey the final decision of supreme court. To semti international jo court of justice achi ताको समस्ते मानती नहीं. Then you will find that our global system is very close to a anarchical system, anarchical society. It is because of that anarchical nature of the system, war happens. Then there is scarcity of resources, right? United Nations पाखरे ऐते पैसा नहीं. Right, to handle the situation, the handle the crisis that happens in the world. And there is, class of civilization, jonta Huntington e theory ta deichanti, je kahiki na se koichanti, je in future you may find the ethno-religious war, among individual. So pratyek desha bhitare, different ethnic group, based on their identity politics, they will start a war. Various kinds of ethnicity, various issues, they will be involved in the war, and simultaneously they will have war against the state. So this is system level cause or system level approach. And the second is the state level approach. So to state level cause, to this approach, the nation state and its internal process is the key determinant of world politics. There is a state-centric, this is a state-centric approach. It believes state has a greater independence in their decision-making. State-level cause kaun kahuchi? Na, jo war hochi, the state is mainly responsible for the war. Kahinki? Na, the state is independent in the decision making, right? Mane state bahyo structure dwara ete affected hobo nahi. Kahinki na bahyo structure ete strong nuha, but state is very strong. Why state is very strong? Na state has its territory, state has its people, state has the has its sovereign power, and state is independent. Independent in taking the decision. Tenu jane jetebele konosi conflict ba konosi war hochi, that war is not because of the world system, rather than it is a conscious act of the nation state. And within a state there would be both structural and non structural determinants to making of policies. Now, if a state is primarily responsible for the war, then state bhitre bhi both structural determinant achanti, non-structural determinant achanti. What is the structural determinant? Now, structural determinant is the nature of the government. What is the non-structural determinant? Now, non-structural determinant, it constitute the political culture of a state. For example, Nabakana, now if you see the authoritarian government and the democratic government, then you will find that democratic government, it will not go to war, but authoritarian government it will go to the war. So authoritarian government and democratic government would differ in their policy formulation. The democratic government jaha bhi kichi policy formulation kariba, authoritarian government sebhaliya policy formulation kebhi bhi karibo. That is the structural determinant, right? Authoritarian form of government or democratic form of government, they will have different policy. In democratic form of government, the policy is anti-war in nature, and in the authoritarian form of government, the policy is pro-war in nature. Then, if you come to the non-structural determinant within the state, then you may find that policy in the times of crisis and policy in the times of peace would be different, right? Say the democratic state, suppose I'm India katha naba, the democratic state, when it is in crisis, then it may decide to go for war. But when the democratic state is in its peace mood, then it may not go to the war. So that is the non-structural determinant of within the state. So at state level analysis, the causes of war are following. The first, the supremacy of national interest is the central driving forces. Tamane state justifies war, and the justification is that we have a national interest, and at anyhow we have to achieve our national interest. So supremacy of national interest is the central driving force used by the state generally ee argumenta use kari tha. And the second, to divert domestic attention elsewhere, tamane state war ko kahi ki jai thai na, suppose kete kichi domestic problem hoichi na, oi domestic problem re hue to lokoman kar attention asile, lokomane state ro legitimacy ko question put karibe, to avoid the public attention, the state may go to the war. Thus kichi loko bi kahanti ki modi jo amaro surgical strike jonda Pakistan upare kale, it is a kind of war. The intention is to divert the attention from Nirav Modi, divert the attention from different corruption cases. Now the non BJP political party they raise this point. Now the state go to war in order to divert attention from domestic issue. And the third cause is that nature of society. Now democratic society less likely to go for war than authoritarian society. That means jona ki mu purvaru kahi sarichi, democratic state war virodhi hoitai, but authoritarian state ye sarvada war ra for ba sapakshare ye war ra jai thai. then the third approach is the individual level cause. To individual level cause or to this approach, war begins in the mind of men. Hence it is the mind of men that the defense of peace must be constructed. So dhire dhire eta system ru state aduku asila, state ru human mind porjanta eta pahunchi gala. Now this approach focuses on human nature, especially the psychological factor and biological factor, and biopolitics examines the relationship between the physical nature and political behavior of men. Ta mane se kon kahuchi jodi purva class ko mane rakhibo, I said that female they are the first peacekeeper, but it is the aggression of men that is they are the brand ambassador of war. Kahin ki na men tankaro psychology aur tankaro biological structure emiti hei thai, they if you are a man then you should fight. If you are not fighting then you are not a man. Jota ame kuche mardangi jota ame kahuche. So this approach focuses on human nature of men, especially the psychological aspect of men, biological aspect of a man, and this biopolitics it examines the relation between the physical nature and political behavior. Why men they do and they think differently from women. So another dimension of this approach is the group behavior, and why do mobs turn into violent? Jonda me lynching kotha kouche se kouche kahi ki gote hatat gote bhidote ekathi ki kahi ki sie violent hei jae kahi ki hei jae. Now to this approach it is argued that individuals as individual may not show aggressive behavior. So when I am alone then I may not show my aggression, but when I am with my near and dear, I am with my family, I am with my community, then aggression comes to me. So it is argued that individuals as individual may not show aggressive behavior, but when they are part of a mob they are likely to commit atrocities. Now this is the group behavior. I mean, individually I am a very peaceful person, but that when that peaceful person becomes part of a group, then he may commit atrocities. So at individual level analysis, the cause of war are following. First, a decision by leader in the name of protecting national interest. Jontaki ame kahi pariba Germany, you can take the example of Hitler. Hitler see gote war, monger. He's a war monger personality, right? See sadabale justify kon kortile na see tankar jo war monger personality thila seita ko se tike parda pachre luchautile au see seita ko state ra national interest sito connect kari doutile. And see war pai sarvada ready rahutile au तंकर भाषण भी एते उच्च कोटीर थिला कि समस्तनक भितरे युद्ध करबा पई गोटे इच्छा को से जागृत करे पडुथले. देन द सेकंड ह्यूमन एग्रेसिव टेंडेंसी बेस्ड ऑन एनिमल एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन जोंटा के हमें कहबा डार्विन इवोल्यूशन थ्योरी जोंटा लास्ट क्लास रे भी मु कहितली फॉर योर एक्जिस्टेंस मे कॉज टू माय एक्जिस्टेंस. Hence, I must kill you for my existence, right? So, setu bi gote war or temperament, main manko pakku eta asitha, right? That is the human aggressive tendency. We all have certain kind of aggression. Then the last point is the frustration and misperception as the main reason of aggressive behavior. Why individuals are aggressive? They are aggressive because either they are frustrated, they are not happy of anything, happy of what is happening around them, they are not happy. Things are not happening according to his wish, or that individual has misunderstood, has misperceived. This may be the reason he may go to the war. So from this analysis, three levels of analysis, you may find there may be different reasons for the war. So here I am stopping actually. Thaki galeni mu, I cannot speak more. It's already 1:30.
All right.
So thank you.
All right. Okay. Thank you so much, Dr. Mukhopadhyay, Mr. Sir. Describe this three unit of our block one so beautifully. You rightly pointed out the conceptual analysis of peace and conflict studies. Basically, you discuss about how peace and how conflict itself is a instinct of a human being. And in society, if you go everywhere in the world, you can find the people are the self-instinct, as you mentioned in your presentation about the Thomas Hobbes and Rousseau. So it is a sense of understanding to think the concept of the contextualize the peace and conflict in the international arena. You clearly discuss about the nature of conflict and interstate conflict. Basically, the interstate is like between the within the state and the sorry interstate is like the between the two state, and interstate is that the conflict between within the states. And the global conflict, as you
within
know, it's a global conflict, as you know, it's a broader concept. And when we discuss about the theory of war, you clearly mention about how the limited war, how the conventional war, and what is the nuclear war. Like in the last class also, we have discussed the limited conventional and nuclear war in the international arena. So thank you so much for your presentation. So we have 4 or 5 questions, then we'll discuss, then we'll talk up with our students. So let's first take the question, then we'll you can speak with the student. The first question is, hello sir, you are writing, right?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
The first question is, what is the means of managing conflict between different states? Will conflict be
managing,
removed, managing between different states? Will conflict be removed in the long run, or it will be continued forever?
ସେକେଣ୍ଡ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନଟା କ'ଣ ଆଉଥରେ?
ନା ସାର୍ ସେଥିରେ ଅଛି, ସେଥିରେ ଅଛି,
ୱାନ୍ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ
ନା ସାର୍ ସେ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ ସେଥିରେ ଅଛି।
ଓକେ
ୱିଲ୍ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ବି ରିମୁଭ୍ଡ ଇନ୍ ଦ ଲଙ୍ଗ ରନ୍ ଅର୍ ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ କଣ୍ଟିନ୍ୟୁ ଫରେଭର?
ୱିଲ୍ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ୱିଲ୍ କଣ୍ଟିନ୍ୟୁ,
ନେ ୱିଲ୍ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ୱିଲ୍ ବି ରିମୁଭ୍ଡ ଇନ୍ ଦ ଲଙ୍ଗ ରନ୍ ଅର୍ ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ କଣ୍ଟିନ୍ୟୁ ଫର ଏଭର? ହଁ, ଦ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ ଇଜ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ଭେରିୟସ୍ ପସିବଲ୍ ରେସ୍ପନ୍ସ ଟୁ ରିସଲ୍ଭ ଦ ଇଣ୍ଟରଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ?
ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ
ଭେରିୟସ୍ ପସିବଲ୍ ରେସ୍ପନ୍ସ ଟୁ ରିସଲ୍ଭ ଦ ଇଣ୍ଟରଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇଣ୍ଟ୍ରାଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ?
Interstate and intrastate.
And the last question is, what are the method of conflict resolution? ଆଉ ଗୋଟେ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍ ଅଛି ସାର୍, ବେସିକାଲି ଇଟ୍ସ ନଟ୍ ଏ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚନ୍, ଇଟ୍ସ ଅବଜର୍ଭେସନ୍ ବେସିକାଲି। ହି ୱାଣ୍ଟେଡ୍ ଟୁ ନୋ ସମ୍ ମୋର୍ ଦ କମ୍ପୋନେଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଗ୍ଲୋବାଲ୍ ୱାର୍, ସୋ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଟେକ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଲେଟର୍ ଅନ୍। ଓକେ ସାର୍, ଗେରି ଅନ୍।
ସୋ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ମିନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ମ୍ୟାନେଜିଂ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ବିଟୁଇନ୍ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ସ, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ political science re I said earlier, the state understanding of state is very much confusing here. State means India or state means Odisha, right? So if state means Odisha, then we have you know, interstate council, right? We have constitution, we have federalism, federal principles, we have prime minister, we have supreme court, we have high court, right? We have local governments. So within India, if you understand state is Odisha as a state, then these are the various means of managing conflicts between the state. Police is also a means of ending the conflict. But if you understand India as a state, now managing conflict, it not necessarily mean that you should go to the war. You can also handle diplomatically. But when scholars think that war is a part of diplomacy, if war is a part of diplomacy, then you may think about non-physical war. What is a non-physical war? ନନ୍ ମିଲିଟାରୀ ୱାର୍ ଆମେ ଯେଉଁଟା କହୁଛେ, କ'ଣ ନା ଯେଉଁଟାକୁ ଆମେ କହୁଛେ ଗୋଟେ ସାଇକୋଲୋଜିକାଲ, ଆମେ କହିପାରିବା ଗୋଟେ ଇକୋନୋମିକ ଇକୋନୋମିକ ୱାର୍, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ଦି ନନ୍ ମିଲିଟାରୀ ୱାର୍। ସୋ ଥ୍ରୁ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇନ୍ଫ୍ଲୁଏନ୍ସେସ୍ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ମ୍ୟାନେଜ୍ ଦି କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ, ବଟ୍ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ନଟ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଦି କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ। ସୋ ମ୍ୟାନେଜିଂ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ, ରିଡ୍ୟୁସିଂ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ, ଆଉ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରରେ ବି ମ୍ୟାନେଜ୍ ହେଇପାରିବ। ଫର୍ ଏକ୍ସାମ୍ପଲ୍, ତୁମେ ଯଦି ନିଜର ନ୍ୟାସନାଲ୍ ପାୱାରକୁ ଆଗକୁ ନେବ, ବହୁତ ଉପରକୁ ନେଇଯିବ, ରାଇଟ୍? ଗୋଟେ ପାୱାରଫୁଲ୍ ଲୋକ ସତରେ ଆମେ କେବେ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ କରୁନା, ଆମକୁ ଡର ଲାଗେ। ତେଣୁ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ଇନ୍ କନଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ, ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ସୁଡ୍ ଡେଭଲପ୍ ୟୁର ରିସୋର୍ସେସ୍, ଡେଭଲପ୍ ୟୁର ନ୍ୟାସନାଲ୍ ପାୱାର, ଡେଭଲପ୍ ୟୁର ଇକୋନୋମି, right? This is also another way of managing conflict, but you cannot end the conflict. Conflict is an ever present phenomena. It will stay, but if conflict will not properly managed, then it may turn into violence. Now violence, you can find in violence there is destruction, right? So conflict is not a bad idea. Conflict is good, conflict is not bad. So if there is no conflict, then there is no progress also. Here I am justifying the conflict. And the second question is, will conflict be removed or continue? I said it. Conflict cannot be removed. Conflict is a ever present phenomena. Conflict must and should continue? And the second question, what are the various possible responses to resolve interstate and intrastate conflict? Here basically interstate means at the societal level, there is a civil society, there is a family, there is a elder, you know. If they will not be perceived, then they can do something so that the conflict will not go to the legal sphere. The state will not intervene in your matter. You know, there are certain conflict. It must be personal. And once it goes beyond the personal, then the relationship becomes very legal. The relationship it may between the husband wife, it may brothers, it may between the father and the son, right? And so far as the intrastate conflict, intrastate means within the state. Within the state means muethi state ko puni Odisha hisabre nauchi. And within Odisha mane kona na it is a intra-societal inter-societal conflict by intra-societal conflict. For intra-societal or inter-societal conflict, civil society plays a major role. But if the civil society is very much passive, then the state takes its own course of action. आउ एठे डरिबा भी उचित नहो. पुलिस जुडिशियरी एमाने तुम कॉन्फ्लिक्ट को समाधान करिबा पई ही अछंती. यू शुड नॉट अफ्रेड ऑफ पुलिस, यू शुड नॉट अफ्रेड ऑफ यू नो कोर्ट सिस्टम. एंड व्हाई दिस पुलिस एंड कोर्ट आर देयर? इट इज बिकॉज यू आर नॉट एबल टू सॉल्व योर प्रॉब्लम, यू आर नॉट एबल टू यू नो मेंटेन एंड सस्टेन द पीस. So by with their involvement, the peace can be sustained. So one should not be afraid of that. Then the third question is that what is the methods of conflict resolution? Already mu kahisaleni, interstate pai tara alga methods achi, global conflict pai tara alga method achi. But the fourth question is that in the component of global war, global war actually touch kari nahi, then I prefer not to answer it. It's already there in the material. If you read, you can understand. Material is very lucid actually. So thank you.
Okay. Let me respond to global war, the brief component of global war. Basically, when you talk about the global war in the context of international relations, let's discuss the whole world, like the NATO forces are involved with the war in Afghanistan, right? This is the global war. The whole world, the members of all the NATO forces are involved in the involved in Afghanistan to eliminate the extremist group in Afghanistan. So the components are basically when a particular set of extremist group are in the form of non-violence, like which is impact on the international level. For example, the Taliban's were attacked the World Trade Center or Two Tower in the US. Basically, the World Trade Center is the main hub for the all the international states to control the trading systems of the world. So once extremist group attack to a particular thing which is impact on the national or international level, then the whole world, the member of whole world will counter to that particular group, and which is you can see in the Afghanistan, like the Afghanistan, the US and NATO forces has been involving in Afghanistan since 14-15 years. So these are the component of the global war and the global conflict. So thank you so much, sir, for your presence, and like I really always fascinate on your speak, on your session, on your lecture. So let's discuss with our students. You want to interact with them. So I request all the learners, please share their views, share their ideas. Jodi se sankor padhebar kichhi kichhi bujhi parunanti ki kichhi au kichhi improvement chahuchanti sankor resources mane tale se kotha lagi parebe. Mu request korchi Dilip Kumar Sahu ku se jodi kichhi koiba pai chaibe. Dilip Kumar Sahu, are you there? Anyway, whoever want to speak, he can speak. Or second
sir,
speak.
Sir, can you hear me, sir?
Yes. Please, sir, carry on.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, we can hear you.
Hello.
Yes, yes, hello.
Hello.
Yes, I can hear you.
Sir, can you hear me, sir?
I can hear you.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, we can hear you, sir.
Sir, first of all, let me offer a good appreciation that you have given the one example of the North Balasore, because I belong to the North Balasore, so I do have a special appreciation for you. And my gratitude to both of you, sir, and Antarjami sir, and also you, sir, Himanshu Mishra sir. Especially your way of teaching is very, very, effective. I think we are getting so much of benefit out of it, and we have the opportunity to at least clear our doubts, and that is the most important thing. Because I think through these virtual classes, I think most of us as a learner, we are getting a lot of benefits, sir. Really, sir. Thank you, both of you, sir. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, Himanshu, sir, do you want to ask anything or like?
It's just a, you know, feedback. It's just a feedback from them. Okay. So feedback may be positive, feedback may be negative.
Yes,
so
yes.
Those who want something extra, something more, they can also ask me in my next talk. I can add it so that it will give benefits to all those, you know, serious scholar or students.
Okay. Anybody want to speak with sir? Anybody? Yatish Sharma, Sipta Patel, Gita Roth, Mukti Saho, anybody?
They are my students actually.
You talk to those
who are part and parcel of Odisha State of an University.
Some students I even don't know if they are from Odisha State of an University or Sombolpur University. Anyway,
how many your students are there actually?
10 or 12, I think they left everybody. Some students.
Sir. I am listening, sir.
All right. You already spoke, sir.
Okay. Yeah, sir. Sir, actually, sir, thing is that I like to extend my gratitude to both of you, sir. That is what I, because basically I am a teacher, sir, and I am learners of the fourth year. And so basically I am a teacher, sir. Hello, sir. Can you hear me, sir? Basically, I am a teacher, sir. And so I am the learner of the fourth semester. This is my last semester, I think, here. So I have been listening to you in all the, I think, attending all the virtual classes. I even do not miss. Whenever I get the messages, I attend all the virtual classes. And really, sir, I am thankful to both of you. And actually, personally, I feel that it is very, very useful for me. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much, Suryan. Now the time to thank you, sir. On behalf of Odisha State of an University, I would like to thank Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra for his time and for his effort to complete the three unit in the session, three unit in the class, block one. So you keep my request and you stand on my words, and I am thank you for your support and for your coordination to complete the three units in a session. And secondly, I would also like to thank our technical person, Devashish Barik. He has been so kind to us, and he's been providing technical support throughout the online class session. And he's been so kind, and he's been so in touch with you and to me and to whole process. And I would also request Devashish to please do send the recording to our resource person by the evening, through which he get benefit and he get out feedback from his lecture only. And not but the least, I would thanks to Odisha State of University to provide me some platform for arrange online classes. Thank you so much, sir. The last word you want to say, if you say, want to say.
Thank you very much. And but that's it, I think. It's okay. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.